Hello everybody, I am the Legendary Metroid, today here with the first Splinter Cell game, which is simply titled Splinter Cell Stealth Action Redefined, and I have the original Xbox version, so I get to play today with the Duke, which I have the original, but I like the Duke more. I know I'm weird. So as far as the Splinter Cell series goes, my first introduction to the series was, I have a friend who, back when all I owned was like the, I don't know, DSi and the Wii maybe, he had this on the Xbox at his house, and we got to do a little bit of the co-op together, just not very much, maybe a couple hours. I haven't seen much of it, but 3DS came out, I saw this game sitting around, the 3DS one. Didn't get it with a box, though. That one was actually really fun. I really enjoyed that one. I beat it twice. After that, I found this, which by far one of my favorite games for Wii U gamepad compatibility. A lot of people kind of ignored this game, said it had bad graphics at the time, and really it has pretty solid gameplay. Really enjoyed that one. Picked up this on the PSP. Oh, I was hoping, because the first two, three experiences I had with the series, those were great. I loved them. This game did so... everything was so wrong. It was terrible. You had to look up a walkthrough every 10 minutes because you had to, like, break the game to progress. And it's not even that it's on the PSP. Like, I was fine with it being on the PSP, only one analog stick, stuff like that. They made it work well enough, like, sort of controlling it, but gameplay was terrible, AI was terrible, there was really, like, odd level design choices. So many things about this game didn't work. Other than that, I picked up pretty much the entire series. I think I'm missing, like, one mainline game, but I was thinking that this would be a fun series to go through, especially since I'm still really busy with college and, well, as much time as I can really make for videos like this, it's much easier if I can skip the editing process or really minimize it, and that's what I think I'm going to be doing with this series. So I'm probably just going to do, like, a mission per episode or something like that, unedited, and I think this entire series is going to be without face cam. So, I know that sounds kind of odd, but given the type of game that it is, where it's not just about, like, hey, let's play a game, let's have fun, whatever's happening, my reaction is what's important, it's really about the environment and this, like, the sound design, the visuals, observing things around, and I feel like a face cam would kind of take away from that, especially since that's, like, the entire focus of the franchise. So, I'm really excited to get into this. I've heard that the first game can tend to suck, but everything onwards is pretty good. So hopefully it's really good. If I find it completely unplayable, might have to back down, but it's going to be pretty hard for me to be completely disappointed. Without further ado, let's try this out. Ooh. Cutscene already?
This is going to sting.
Go ahead.
Okay. What is this?
Christ, this is spooky.
What's that?
It's going to sting.
Wires in your head, man.
It's just like putting in an earbud.
Signature between his subdermals and Fort Meade.
Don't like that.
I know. It's for after we land. You better hurry up, Grim. We touched down in Georgia in 15.
I'm already done. Lambert? Hey, Irving, do you read me?
Tell her I read her. He reads you. Good.
Yeah.
You ready to get to work? I'd feel better if I knew what was going on. You know what you need to. The CIA lost a mole inside Georgian President Kombane Nikoladze's cabinet. Her name is
okay.
Alice Madison. They sent in Agent William Robert Blaustein
to
find
rescue
her
mission?
And lost him, too.
Okay.
Are we working with the CIA's cooperation?
Blaustein so, it's basically find one guy's
like
dead
yours.
Body
That'll
and rescue
be your best
a girl.
To find him. You didn't answer my question.
We'll tell you what you need to know. You're not out there alone, Fisher. Through me, you're attached to a dozen of the best NSA minds we have. There are political complexities with Georgia you'd need a week to understand.
I've just about memorized this speech, Lambert.
Well, start believing it. This is Third Echelon's maiden voyage, and we need it to go smooth as butter. You're about to touch down in Georgia. Get ready.
Oh, that got really dark. Is that even easy to see? It's bright again. Locate CIA agents Blaustein and Madison. Agent Allison Madison worked covertly in the Georgian political arena for 2 years, securing a role in resident Nikolazde's cabinet after his coup d'etat. She vanished on October 3rd, and on October 7th, Special Agent Robert Blaustein was sent in to find her. He vanished on October 11th. Okay, yeah. Sorry if I'm reading that a bit slow. It's just, for some reason, being this close to a monitor this big is, it's a bit difficult for me. It might be easier if you're looking at, like, a phone or something, but the font is just a bit tricky when it's really blown up. Okay, save checkpoint. Yeah. I know I said I wouldn't edit this, but I'm gonna cut to right now. Skip the tutorial. Because that took quite a while.
Finding Agent Blaustein is our first priority. We're to locate him through a local NSA contact.
I'm on my way.
And stay off the streets. There's a heavy cop presence in this town. We don't have Washington's backing if this turns into an incident. Details on your offset.
Yeah. So for those who don't know much about the series, basically, I'm part of the Third Echelon, which, even though they pronounce it in game, it's such a weird word to try to pronounce. But basically, we operate outside of, like, everything. Like, no one is on our side, but we're still, like, undercover, if that makes sense. We technically are in favor of America's goals, but no one can, like, publicly support us if we are ever found out. Okay. So I'm on a roof. Basically, we rescue two people, which may or may not be dead. Okay, I got up here. Can I make that jump? Oh, wow. Yep. Can I... Is this a lock I can pick? Nope. Oh yeah, another weird thing in this game. Like, you'd think that your gun is just something, you press left trigger, always have the gun. No, you have to equip it separately from things like the lock pick and the peek under the door tool. Also some bizarre control choices. Oh, can I climb on the vines?
Somebody there?
He can see me. Or hear me. I'm being a bit of an idiot. Can I... Where's the start button? I'm gonna press like black or white because those are buttons on here instead of start and select because they just look like start and select buttons. Okay, is there options? Okay. Data. No options? That's only on the main menu? I didn't realize there'd be so much background music in a game where audio is so important to just gameplay. I'll probably change it next episode or something. So I can't climb on these vines. Going up there doesn't benefit me. I can climb on that pipe, but there'd be no point. Incredibly visible here. Maybe there's something I'm missing. Wow. Things get really blurry at a distance with this. I didn't notice that in training because it was pretty closed. Wish there was a sound meter like future installments, but first game of the series, I'll give it a break. I mean, I found this ladder right away, but... And it seems like something important, but... Wait, can I... I don't know how to jump down there, because all the jump button would do is, like, release me from... Well, that didn't work. Is there even a health meter? Is that what that bar on the right is? That wasn't explained in the tutorial. I never took damage there. Wait, is this door? Is that a door? That's a door! Can I lockpick it? I cannot. Normally it's about, this game should be like about sneaking around enemies, but right now it's just like, look at all the doors that I can't get through, and all the things that I can't climb, and all the things that just don't lead anywhere. I'm only in one room. What do I do? That's only, it's like right where I spawned, there's something happening. Nope, locked. Okay. Gotta get somewhere. Okay. Oh, whoa. I didn't see that. What's that doing there? Okay. Sorry if things look a bit jerky, I have the sensitivity turned up on the controller. That's just what's most comfortable to me for playing it, right now at least. Okay, so I gotta get up there. I don't know if that's high enough. I don't know if I can make that jump. Oh, maybe. Yeah, you can do a wall jump, but only like if you sidestep it or something. Maybe I'm just not meant to grab... Oh, maybe I'm meant to grab that ledge. Okay. Oh, he even does like a realistic turn. He doesn't do a video game character turn where you just like... Oh! Duh! I can climb this. I'm trying to do all these tricky, clever jumps. There's a fire?
Don't tell me. Gergenidze is inside there.
Why would I tell you what you already know? You're gonna have to hurry. Grim's daughter's comparing a Dark Star drone sonar to the warehouse blueprints. She'll be guiding you through.
A lot more checkpoints than I anticipated with a game of this age.
Sam, Grim's daughter here. I say jump. Don't ask how high, just do it. You should get to the spot.
What? Is it just because I kept walking, or does just opening the door automatically mean death? Why do you choose what checkpoint you want to reload at?
Sam, Grim's daughter here. I say jump. Don't ask how high, just do it. You should get through this fine.
Okay.
There's a room directly across the hall. Go there now.
Okay. Yeah, the weird thing is, even with the gun, left trigger does absolutely nothing so far. So, I feel like that'd be a much better use for the toggle. Just skip the fire entirely. Down there is clearly not an option. What? Oh, pipe. Oh, turn around, turn around. Okay. And easy going, but we'll make it eventually, I think. Come on. Sam!
Jesus, but that was close. Take a left just ahead and cut through the room. You'll find a stairwell on the opposite corner.
Yep.
Take it to the top floor.
Yeah, you probably didn't hear because I skipped the tutorial in editing, but... jump button is how you drop from ledges, which can't seem to figure out because I've been playing Breath of the Wild so much, and in that game... Nope. Dang it. Yeah, but in Breath of the Wild, the jump button, like, if you keep pressing it, you keep using, like, stamina, and you can keep climbing further, and I'm just used to abusing the jump button to, like, climb higher. But now I'm playing a game where it's how you let go of ledges, which...
Sam,
I haven't played any games here. Where you let go of ledges by doing it.
Don't ask how high, just do it.
Okay.
You should get through this fine. There's a room directly across the hall.
Yeah,
go
yeah,
there now.
Across the hall, whatever. Great! And then just here, and then jump, and then... No! I didn't jump forward, I jumped up! Dang it. Maybe I'm just dumb. Whatever. Okay. Yeah, mission failed. Just... Why let me select the checkpoint? Just get
Sam, Grimm's daughter here. I say jump. Don't ask how high, just do it. You should get through this fine. There's a room directly across the hall. Go there now.
Oh, this is so white. Okay, I'm jumping into the door frame. Just grab the pipe there. Yeah, I can take him off just by flicking.
Jesus, but that was close.
Nope.
Take a left just ahead and cut through the room.
Yeah, B button is how you climb, and jump
floor.
Button is how you, Is there another door? Oh, that's the shadow. Fire effects. Is this where I started? Okay, wait. Can I? Come on. I can usually do a wall jump thing. What? That looks like the exact same staircase I was in before, but... Wait, what? Is there, like, more than one path available to me?
I say jump. Don't ask how high, just do it. You should get through this fine. There's a room here at the bottom of the hall. Go there now.
Everyone just does that. Okay.
Damn. Sorry about that. Get back into the hall and go to the stairwell at the far end. Get back. We've only got a few seconds.
Fire is so bright. No, no, no. Jump. Don't keep it there.
Jesus, but that was close. Take a left just ahead and cut through
this
the room.
Happens to be
you'll
a game where it feels like
the
button
the
presses
floor.
Are a couple seconds behind, or not a couple seconds, but like half a second or so behind what I press, so I hope that's not just an issue with the thing. The analog sticks are performing like as soon as I hit them, but button presses, those seem delayed. Yeah, that was clearly not an option. This way, like, what do I do? Can I run through that? Okay, that didn't look like something I could do, but...
The contact is in this room. Let's hope to God he's still alive.
How was that?
Gerdinidze.
Yeah.
I'm in the city. I'm gonna get you out of here.
Don't bother. I'm as good as dead.
Okay.
You're looking for Blaustein and Madison.
Yeah.
Madison was deep into Nicolas's cabinet. She was onto something big. Blaustein must have figured it out.
How do I find him?
Blaustein's black box. Tracking the relay for his subdermals.
The audio it's just based on how the camera is.
Safe house just east of Moravi Square.
Lambert, do we have resources to evac this guy?
I said don't bother. Whatever Madison found, it's big. She kept saying proof would mean war. I think Nicolas wanted... Oh.
Gerdinidze checked out.
Leave the corpse for the fire. Less to explain to his family.
You've got a safe exit on the west side of the room. Take it.
This direction is west. I saw a door. That looked like a bridge. I mean, a weak bridge. Who knew if it was something that would stay, but... Don't put me all the way back. It put
Sam,
me all the way back.
Grim's daughter here. I say jump. Don't ask how high, just do it.
How high?
You should get through this fine. There's a room directly across the hall. Go there now.
Just... No?
Jesus, but that was close. Take a left just ahead and cut through the room.
This isn't
You'll find
a left.
A stairwell on the opposite
this
corner.
Is left.
Take it to the top floor.
So this is the dumb part that looks like you'll take tons of damage.
Nothing. Contact is in this room. Let's hope to God.
Can I skip past this?
Gergeninze.
Yeah.
I'm MSA. We're gonna get you out of here.
Don't bother.
Is there a skip?
I'm good at dead.
That's...
You're looking for Blaustein and Matt here.
No skipping?
Blaustein's black box.
Lambert, do we have resources to evac this guy?
Sit.
Gergeninze checked out.
Leave the corpse for the fire.
Okay.
Yes, to explain.
I was just pushing tons of buttons. I didn't figure out what worked.
Side of the room. Take it.
Okay, is that my exit? Whoa, that's pitch. Black. Sprinkler's just sort of trying to work. What happened?
There's too much smoke. Shoot out the skylights.
Skylights? Where's the skylights? I have to equip the gun. And press X. I don't see anything. I'm just shooting. Okay. Apparently just the entire center of the room could be taken out with one bullet. Okay. Okay, next checkpoint or whatever happens. Okay, new checkpoint.
That was pretty tight. You still breathing?
Doing my best.
Good. Blaustein's black box is your next objective. He's running standard agency tradecraft. You'll find the box behind a fake bookshelf or wall panel.
Okay, fake wall.
Hello? Who's there?
Who can see me? Is that just something it's said no matter what? Hey, there's an opening. Can I drop down? How do I hang off a ledge? Oh, I just walk off a ledge to hang.
Yeah, Sam, this mission is too sensitive to have you running around on the streets. Pulling the plug.
Oh, I can't even go on the street. I thought that I was supposed to go on the street.
Was
I supposed to use the...
Doing my best.
Okay, yeah.
Black box is your next objective.
Am I supposed to use this gap to jump? Okay, yeah, jump over here. And press the B button to climb.
Good gringo, because those are my orders. I speak to Vyacheslav Grinko or nobody. As Grinko,
that's
it's
a making noise in the back.
This is Tedeman. We finish searching the American's apartment. There is nothing else there. We need 5 more folks, 2 cameras, and some electronics we can't ID. They are already on their way to the minute.
Well, there's no interrogation option. Normally there is. Sometimes there is. Is Is that guy looking at me already? What the heck is that? That's not fair or really unfortunate. No, you come out.
You're good as dead.
I need a dark place. That'll probably work. Yeah.
You're good as dead.
Oh no. They just have two sound clips and they won't stop using them.
Wherever you are.
Is this guy really not going to? He's not going to let me bait him. Hi. That's a huge TV for what? 2001, 2? When did this come out? Sheesh. Ooh, VHSs. Didn't they already have DVDs for several years by then? Interact. Oh, sweet. Now I have vodka. Great. Oh yeah, I forgot about the roll. Does the roll just make tons of noise, or... Wait, they said it would be behind a bookshelf or something, right? I don't see a way to interact with this. Must be another one. Okay. Oh yeah, even flip light switches make it harder to see. If I didn't already shoot the only guy here in the head, could that be the bookshelf? No. It's probably just in the last room because they want you to progress a bunch. Oh, I don't see it here either. There. Is he using one hand? He's not holding anything in his other hand.
Stopped beating 43 hours ago.
Any reason the CIA wouldn't know about this?
Nope.
Nice of them to share.
The subdermal went offline 6 hours after he died. Last active position was at a police station a few blocks away. Check your OPSAT.
Okay. Wait. How do I back out? Wait, how do I back out from this? Just get it wrong? No. Just there. And then it gives me a brief there. Yeah. Does it say the code? Dead find Gardensky's dead drop. What does that mean? What's this dead drop? But I can interact with something here. I saw an icon. Can't be anything that interesting if it's so hard to find. It's a medkit type game. If only I could actually be sure that the bar on the right was my health or not. Can't get behind that door. So I'm looking for... Where is it? You sure I haven't just found it already? It's just like beer and stuff. Great. This doesn't help me. I wonder if I can shoot out the TV. Sweet. Yeah, find Gardensky's dead drop. What does that mean? Does it mean look at the guy that I killed because he's dead or what? Nope. Okay, interact with the body. No, I can't search the body. Okay, so where am I? Where am I looking for this code? Can I see the code, like, on here? No, that's just, like, way too blurry. Okay. Finder. His dead drop. What is his dead drop? Is this backtracking? What am I supposed to look for? Can I break through the window? No, there's bars anyway. Can't find anything to interact with that actually does anything. Could be the guy I knocked out of here. No, can't find anything on his body. What's that? Just another can. Taking it. Oh, that's how you throw it. You have the momentum from your own movement. Okay. And what the heck? I've been like everywhere that's available to me right now. I haven't found a code. I don't know what exactly it's talking about because I just watched that guy die and I can't go back there. Did I like get it and not hear about it? No, it's, yeah. Oh, of course. 09-1772. How did I even get that? No. How did I even get that code? I don't even remember. Or I didn't acknowledge. I don't know what. I didn't see that I had gotten it. Close the door. How do I close the door? What the heck? I can't get past. Do I need to get past? Oh, zip line. Why is there always someone saying that? It's supposed to be stealthy. Why is it like, why are they programmed to like say that that they know I'm here like as soon as I start to show up? Okay, it's too bright. I can't do anything with those. Okay, yeah, I can grab that. Yep, nope, stop grabbing it. No. There. Now, open the trap door. Dive in. Jump in. Come on.
Fisher, I'm rescinding my street level restriction. They've been monitoring the Tbilisi police radio. These cops are as crooked as a Virginia fence. They're not going to want any more international attention than we do. Every road is open to you. Do what you gotta do to find those missing spooks.
Okay, door locked, so... Okay. This is why I like Splinter Cell Blacklist so much, because all of inventory and everything... And there's, like, a dozens more stuff in the inventory in that game than there is in this, but... It's all just on the touchscreen, and a lot of the gadgets, like, it really uses the second screen well and stuff, but... This one... A lot of random little... quick menus and stuff. Okay. Picking that. That's the other thing. Even though it shows you 6 tiers for each lock, you never know how many it's going to be before it actually unlocks it. And if you, like, preemptively let go of the control stick, then it, like, starts over. Okay. Checkpoint? Yeah. So for this first episode, I'm just going to do, hopefully, the entire first mission, unless it really drags on, but it's already 1 a.m., I have class in the morning, and the video's supposed to be up the day, like, well, technically today, if you count 1 a.m. as being part of the day.
I think we could set you up with this lab real easy. I've done nothing. Please.
So that gives a bit of an example of
this. How about drunk and disorderly? Assaulting a police officer? Slandering the badge?
You said we're associated with criminals.
I think we're supposed to ignore
then
them.
Arrest me. I must sleep. Weren't you listening?
The rent's gone up in jail.
You want to die tonight? That's free. You want to sleep tonight? It'll cost you 100 lari.
Oh, please. I don't.
Now what are we going to do?
Oh, they heard me. I think. Oh, two shots dead. Fell through a wall. Well, that went quick. Yeah. Camera sensitivity, I'm glad that you can do a bit with that. Not much, but... Or, I'm glad where the camera sensitivity is in the game, but... Movement sensitivity, it is...
What do you think you're doing? Prison cells don't come cheap these days.
Incredibly
precise.
The real
estate is closer to your rent than the morgue.
Slabs are going for cheap.
Yeah, I think we could set you up with this slab real easy. I've done nothing. Please.
Nothing? How about drunk and disorderly? Assaulting a police officer? Slandering the badge?
You said we're associated with criminals. Then arrest me. I must sleep.
Weren't you listening?
The rent's gone up in jail.
Okay.
You want to die?
I didn't want to... Dang it. Well, it's like basically pitch black here, so... No. Oh, this is according to the light meter. Hopefully they'll lose interest soon enough. Really good sound design for the time. I can appreciate that. Okay. Can't like just walk out there, it's too bright. It's shooting me immediately, but basically my... There we go. But basically my goal is to jump up on that ledge because I'll be getting around them. No, I didn't want to... Holy crap, that was weird.
Who's there?
Back in the shadows. Why isn't left trigger pull out the gun? Left trigger does absolutely nothing. It's so weird. Wait, how do I reload? Aha. No! Well, that time I died in one shot. Yeah, aiming is pretty inaccurate in this. You didn't see me go through the tutorial, but it's pretty weird. Even if you're 10 feet away from something and aren't moving your like aim at all, or like you just aren't using the right analog stick, it's just pointing in one place, you will hit like 10 different places if you take 10 different shots. They like all go slightly off center.
I think we can set you up with this lab real easy. I've done nothing. Please.
Nothing? How about drunk and disorderly? Assaulting a police officer? Slandering the badge?
You said we're associated with criminals. Then arrest me. I must sleep.
Weren't you listening?
The rent's gone up in jail.
You want to die tonight? That's free. You want to sleep tonight? It'll cost you 100 lari.
Oh, please.
What's a lari?
I don't.
Don't move too fast.
Now what are we going to do with him?
Check his pockets. I'll radio HQ.
Sure.
Unit 3 to dispatch. We have a 1053.
This door
possible
won't
assault.
Help me.
Can you send an ambulance?
Copy that, Unit 3. But we're dealing with a warehouse fire, so expect delay.
Roger that, dispatch. We'll wait with the victim. Unit 3 out.
So there is a guy over
something
there.
Something we can pin on Costa.
Good thinking.
I think I'm good to run past here. Nope. There's a guy. Yeah, night vision makes things in the distance blurry. Like, super blurry. And this game already looks pretty blurry by what most people are used to. I think we're just gonna sneak past. No, he heard me. He's shooting at me. Sneak! Sneaky! Oh wait, X button just automatically has the gun out no matter what the scenario. See what I mean? I was aiming at least close enough to him and not much luck there. Aiming is really jittery. I'm used to like aiming controls just always centering back to like your main focus point. But in this one, it always, if you let go of the stick, it just, it's right where you
left
it.
What do you think you're doing? Prison cells don't come cheap these days.
The real estate is closer to your rent than the morgue.
Slabs,
you have no idea how slight you have to press the analog stick to crawl like this. It's so
slab real easy.
Please. Nothing? How about drunk and disorderly? Assaulting a police officer? Slandering the badge?
You said we're so
What's slandering the badge?
Then arrest me. I must sleep.
Weren't you listening?
The rent's gone up in jail.
You want to die tonight? That's free. You want to sleep tonight? It'll cost you 100
Oh, that's
lari.
That guy whistling.
Please, I don't.
Now what are we? Check his pockets. I'll radio HQ.
Sure.
Unit 3 to your bed.
What? I shot him twice. That usually kills him. Dang it. I moved too fast. That's the hardest part. The sound. Like, they detect your sound so easily. Which wouldn't be a problem if it wasn't just how slight you have to touch the analog stick in order to do it.
What do you think you're doing?
Because this controller has pretty stiff analog sticks. And you have to do it extremely slightly.
I think we could set you up with this slab real easy. I've done
like, I'd say, like, a fifth or a sixth as far. No? What the? Okay, that just didn't work. Kill me as well. I guess I ever so slightly didn't grab the ledge, so try again.
What do you think you're doing? Prison cells don't come cheap these days.
The real estate is closer to your rent than the morgue.
Slabs are going for cheap.
Yeah, I think we could set you up with this slab real easy. I've done nothing. Please.
Nothing? How about
well, turned around right then.
Assaulting a police officer? Slandering the badge?
Okay, yeah.
You said we're associated with criminals. Then arrest me.
So I didn't realize that guy right there turned around halfway through. Really? Really? That triggered him. Maybe if I just wait him out. Yeah, because they're not going to, like, walk through the fence or anything. I can just wait till they lose interest. Nope, I can't. This guy's gonna turn back here. No, he isn't. He gives up. Yep, you are.
Must have been nothing.
Almost as crazy as me. Oh, that guy's coming back. No, he's not. Can't tell if he's looking this way, but it should be dark enough to not cause an issue. I don't know what that guy's. Let me see. That doesn't help at all. He's either too blurry or too far. Okay, I just wait for him to come back, I guess. I think I'm past the other two. They're not. They don't have a reason to come over here unless I get alerted. Or unless the other guy alerts them about it. But I can always just take about. Well. I hope I can. And again, if he takes, like. I tried shooting him twice, it didn't kill him, but. If he takes more. What? I didn't even move. I was in pitch black. I guess just after you're close enough, they detect you anyway. So what's the strategy there? Like, follow him. But your sneak is... Like, if you want the sound to also be sneaky, then... You can't move fast enough to catch up behind him, so...
Real estate is closer to your rent and the more...
Maybe you can.
Slabs are going for cheap.
Yeah, I think we could set you up with this slab real easy.
Okay. I've done nothing. Please. Nothing? How about drunk and disorderly? Assaulting a police officer? Yep, yep, slandering the badge?
You said we're associated with criminals.
So crouch here.
Ah, then arrest me. I must sleep. Weren't you listening?
The rent's gone up in jail.
You want to die tonight? That's free. You want to sleep tonight? It'll cost you 100 lari.
But please, I don't... Oh.
Check his pocket.
I thought I was dark enough.
HQ. Sure. Unit 3 to dispatch. I have it. Copy that.
Sheesh. This game is very specific with so many factors. Okay.
What do you think you're doing? Prison cells don't come cheap these days.
Even in the PSP game, I got used to it was just kind of like. Like, in all three of the games that I've played, I think even Pandora Tomorrow, so the fourth game I played, I feel like there weren't as many little specific things. Like, the movement is pretty unusual because of how specific certain inputs need to be. Especially, like, walking to keep quiet is so precise on the analog stick. It's more difficult than just playing the game. It's just like trying to keep it so precise on there. Like, that's why I'm steering using the camera instead of using my character, because it just doesn't work otherwise.
I've done nothing.
No! I didn't even press a button to do that. I guess if you're just too high on the staircase, you automatically climb up. Dang it. I am moving as slow as I... Okay. He was literally facing the complete opposite direction. And I was moving as slow as I possibly could. And he detected me. Is there, like, no way to beat this. People have beaten this game. This game wouldn't have been popular enough to get a sequel if people couldn't get past this.
What do you think
this.
You're doing?
But this Prison is so broken.
Don't come cheap these days.
The real estate is closer to your rent in the morgue.
Slap. Oh.
Yeah, has that I been the solution all along? There's a guy up there. He's the one who alerts them once I get into the light.
Nothing? How about drunk?
But if shooting anyone alerts everyone, then how can I still do this? I'd need to kill all of them in order to progress. Unless the game just has like programming where only certain characters trigger everyone's attention.
You want to die tonight? That's free. You want to sleep tonight? It'll cost you 100 lari.
But I don't have enough precision to.
I don't.
Don't kill me!
That was an innocent guy? Okay, then what is the problem I have with this? Oh, and he just comes back out anyway? What? They are alerted, and I have yet to even do anything. I'm just gonna try shooting everyone, see if that helps. I only have like 30 shots, which... I mean, that's not how you're supposed to play this game, but I've been stuck on this for, let's see, 50 minutes.
Sergei, I want you and your men to check it out.
There's some guy in the window. Okay. Oh, there's a stairwell up there. Okay, so I'm gonna see what's up here. Locked doors. Okay, what the heck? Oh, it's just the bottles. Oh wow, those are even swaying in the wind. They definitely tried with this game. Is this supposed to be like a chair? What the heck is this? It's weird looking. Why is it playing this music still? That won't work. Wait, what am I seeing in there? Is it fog or something? Fountain's making a lot of noise, music's making a lot of noise, but... glass everywhere for fun, because I don't know what else to do here. I don't know if I skipped past it, but yeah, I switched controllers twice. I have three Xbox controllers, and like one original, or two Dukes, and a regular, or a small, or slim, or whatever they're called. And all of them are having these buggy controls, so it's definitely not controllers, it's the game with the input delays, which I've played other games on the Xbox. They do not have that issue at all. Analog sticks don't have a delay, but buttons. Oh my goodness, there's a delay. I cannot figure out what to do with this. There's no, like, hint system, so nothing, like, pops up. I can't climb any of these things. Wait. I thought I saw something through there. Wait, what was... Are you kidding me? What the heck? Who's going to find that? Like, what? Oh, maybe with night vision you could tell. That's why. You need night vision to see it. But that was so hard to find. Save checkpoint, sure. Okay, well... You know what, Is it coming for the Xbox? Wow, that's a louder console than I remember. So I'm going to end it right there. Yeah, I'm gonna end it here, and it's not what I was hoping. It's also kind of what I've been told, like, this game is broken because of, like, this game in the series was broken because of level design and AI, and then these two that I played were great, everything in it was fun. This one, I've been told that the first one is significantly worse than the rest of the franchise, and I can see why. Very much so. It is. Oh my goodness. The mechanics in this, they're so buggy. Like, no matter what controller I use, like, I'm getting input delays. I'm getting weird movement issues. Like, I don't know how precise you can see on there. Yeah, I know it's not a first-party controller. That's just what I have. But, like, that's like a normal movement. That should be running speed or walking speed. That's like half. That should be just normal. That's like hardly anything. You will still be hurt if you're moving that much. That's the center. Like, look. See that? That is how much you have to move to be moving at full speed silent. And then somewhere in the mid-range of that is moving even slower and silent. It is so precise. And the analog sticks on here, like, they're so clicky. They're so stiff in the middle. It's just baffling how the biggest mechanic is so hard to perform because of how precise it is on the controller. It's not a fun game to play. Every other game in the series I've played has been at least somewhat fun to play. I mean, gameplay-wise. This one, buttons have input delays, weird button mapping, where I suppose I could get used to it, but it's just so unusual. The AI, they're hit or miss on all kinds of things. How many shots it takes to kill you, how many shots it takes to kill them, can you even aim in the game, what counts as shadows, who's identifying you. There's a lot to be desired. I'm definitely going to come back in a sec, try to come back in a second episode, finish this mission, but chances are I'm just going to be done with the game. I can definitely see why, like, like, the first three I've played, I don't remember how much those cost, but, like, each of these were, like, when I picked them up, they were, like, $10, $15, $20 games. Actually, I don't think any of them were $10. They were all, like, $15 or $20 when I picked them up. $2. Like, I think it's... Where is it? Yeah. The receipt is right in there. $2. It's... I know why it's that cheap. It's part of a series that became good, but it's not good. It's not a good game. I'm not having fun with it. But I don't want to disregard the series for this because I've seen what they can do and I'm very impressed with the overall quality of it, but from what I've heard, first one is underwhelming, second one, everything right, kind of pulling like an Assassin's Creed, I guess you could say, but I'll finish the mission in another episode. Not gonna come back to it after that, most likely. But if there really is like no support for this episode, I might just be done with it here. But if you want to see me at least try a bit more of the game, let me know down below in the comments. Most likely, one episode. If no one's supporting this in the first place, nothing else, and I'll just start off with the second one right off. But that was Splinter Cell 1, the first one to come out on the original Xbox, Stealth Action Redefined. And it has a rating of 9.6 according to the box. Nope!